Alright, so we're gonna take down Shadow Labyrinth yet, guys. Note that I've said it a couple of times already, but throughout some of my beginning videos, is that this is the first Persona 4 Arena episode I've done on the Xbox Series X, bro. You might think how the hell is this the first one if you already had a Series X for a while by this point? Well, it's because in past episodes, I actually filmed the past few episodes prior to getting the Series X, bruh. So yeah. So I usually just film multiple episodes within a week and then release and then spread them out over a span of like a few weeks. So yeah, that's how I filmed this shit, bro. How dare you corrupt Labyrinth, bro. Motherfucker. Bookmark the shit, bro. And it feels a lot faster, though. Labyrinth's shell collapses and stops moving. Thank goodness. It seems that I managed to win. All that's left for us is for Labyrinth to accept her shell, and it should put an end to everything. But the weight of the past Labyrinth is harboring isn't a normal thing. When anyone goes through tough times, the witch that normal people would experience, the pain arises in everyone's mind at one point or another. But pain from her past comes from her being forced to kill her friends. Yeah, bruh. And it sucks too. Because she really was close to her fellow robots. Only to find out that the scientist was just using them as super weapons, bro. And hell, they were even using Labyrinth for their own personal gain to fight, just to fight Shadows, bro. It's incomparable to the problems I need to face last year. I was forced to hurt Chie until she died. I think I go insane in the snap. I wonder if she'll be okay. I call her Labyrinth while my heart is pounding. Labyrinth answers in a teary voice. I have to support her. There's no way I could understand everything she's gone through. I want to support her because there are things I can't understand.
Why did you save me? You already know I'm a machine that's supposed to protect people. But because of what they did to me was so painful, I took it out on other people too. So why are you? It's okay. You must have suffered so much. I'm sorry. You went through so much pain to protect us. But it's all right now. I won't let those things happen to you anymore.
Alright. Labyrinth looks up in response to my words. When I think about when Labyrinth protected us from her shell, how she closed off her heart and reverted to the mechanical self that she never wanted to show it, anyone makes my heart ache. Never want her to have to go through that again. Labyrinth has already lived through so much pain, so many painful experiences. Because of that, I can never truly say that I understand her feelings. But I'm sure that I can at least protect her so that she won't have to go through the same shit all over again, bro.
It doesn't matter if you're human or not. I'm your friend. We made a promise, remember? You want to be friends?
Mm-hmm. Be friends. We're friends already. That's why if you're going through tough times, I'll always be there to help you through and protect you. Labyrinth seems genuinely surprised. She probably doesn't realize it, but she doesn't look anything like a machine when she makes faces like that. I can tell that you truly have a heart.
I've faced my own shadow too. I wanted to blame everything on someone else because I felt so powerless. I was waiting for someone to do my work for me. I wanted to escape from my life, so I dreamed that a prince would take me away. But my friends helped me realize that was just me trying to run from my problems.
I recount my own personal experiences for Labyrinth. It's the same as what Labyrinth went through a moment ago. She has feelings, experiences that she didn't ever want other people to know about, because they were all true. It makes it even harder to accept them, so she rejects them. Labyrinth has a heart just like I do.
The reason I could accept my weakness and fight this to the very end is because I had my friends helping me. I had friends who worried about me, who stood beside me. I wasn't alone.
Smile, Labyrinth, just as Yukun did for me back then.
And that gave me unimaginable strength. You're not alone anymore either. I'm sure you'll be able to find a place where you belong, too.
Merely your own weakness. Weakness isn't scary. No one wants to see their weakness. But I know that it's possible if you don't have to face it alone. When Labyrinth hears my words, the light returns to her eyes. I can sense a strong will from her that must be from her heart. I'm so glad that my words got through to her. Labyrinth nods reassuringly and then begins walking towards her shadow. She takes the steps towards her own weakness. I know. I know I've seen this a couple of times, so yeah. But don't worry, bro. We're only gonna see this, like, when it comes to the actual story mode, bro.
You are me, after all.
But I'm still planning on doing arcade mode, though. It's just after this story mode, bro. So I've just realized that the arcade mode is basically a short version of story mode, essentially, bro. Chan contacted us soon after. She must have detected Xiao's presence in this year, and we were able to join up with each other. Invisible walls and Tormis wolves have both seen it have stopped once Labyrinth stepped in her own shadow. Yusei Chan used her persona to contact everyone and tell them that everything's been solved. Some of us were surprised to discover that Kanji-kun was here, as well as Naoto-kun, who wasn't even supposed to be in Inaba today. Yusei-chan tells everyone to meet up on the rooftop. What she tells us, the studio-like space connected to Juness seems to have been restored here. The four of us immediately begin to head towards the entrance for Labyrinth stop. When I ask her what's wrong, she responds anxiously.
Can I really come with you? Okay. I'd just be a nuisance. A nuisance? No, I'm a machine. All sorts of problems.
What does she mean by problems? Brother Teddy, I can't think of any possible problems left to cause.
You're saying it wouldn't bother you and your friends?
That's for sure. In any case, there's no way you'd be a nuisance.
You couldn't be safe, Tom. Both laugh out loud. I can't help but giggle along with them. Considering our circumstances, there's nothing all that weird about Labrys. He's not a different of ours, no different from anyone else here. When we reached the entrance area, Yosuke Kun and Chie called to me at once. They've been worried about me ever since I fought against them. Chie notices that Labrys is with me, immediately dashed over the fleet.
Kirijo Group's humanoid weapons actually exist.
Nato-kun seems to know a bit about her already, but yeah. Considering that everyone is here, I think now is a good opportunity to introduce her. Tell everyone everything that happened with Labrys, and with some help from Yukun's submittal comments. As I finish talking, silence washes over the rooftop. Labrys has fallen silent too, looks nervous. Kanji-kun is first to speak.
Again, what's going on? Everything was alright.
The conclusions. You're one of the things that got us into this mess, you know?
Yeah. Wanted to be a dumbass in all, Kanji, bro. Like, man. This nigga is really fucking dumb, bro.
You know?
Are you sure about that, bruh?
Naruto's are pretty crazy, at least.
Don't drag me into this. After the epithet given to Kanji-kun, I imagine that his shadow must have been far, far worse than mine.
Blinks surprised after seeing the group's usual friendly pace. See, I told you that there wouldn't be any problems. When I say that's her, Labrys quietly replies back, man, you were right. And then,
well done, mommy. I had every confidence that you could do this.
I hear a voice behind me. When I turn around, I see Materia-san and two other people. Were they in here looking for Labrys too? Like Materia-san. They both have weird outfits. That person.
It's nice to meet you all. My name is Agus. Thank you very much for saving my sister.
That girl would have lied something to Labrys. Seems to have noticed me. Looking at her and addressing me. Does she mean Labrys? And that means.
Yes, I too am a robot.
She's kind of a later version of what Labrys was built for. Oh, I'm Akihiko Sanada. Sorry for all the troubles.
So, Aya-san is the robot. And Akihiko-san is one wearing a red cape. Okay, I memorized them now. Actually, I guess it would actually be hard to forget them. Yeah, because how unique they are. In contrast to those two, Labrys takes a step back. Her expression is tense. Is she nervous? Of course she is. They came in here looking for her after all. But yeah, I didn't introduce anyone to Masu-san friends. While I'm still flustered, Yukun and Risei-chan officially introduced them to everyone else. And afterwards, Masu-san explained the circumstances of how they ended up here. With us. Well, for us, More like to Labyrinth, though. How this case began by Labyrinth being dropped into TV, how they all pursued her into this world. As Mysterio Son explains, their intentions, Labyrinth seems to get even more nervous. She must be worried. But it's alright. Mysterio Son realizes Labyrinth's emotional state. She turns her gaze towards Labyrinth and kindly smiles to her.
Don't worry. I'm not planning to steal you away again.
I ran wild and caused so much trouble. Maybe not just today, but back then, too.
You've awakened to your persona and gained control over it. You're hardly a rogue test unit anymore. Besides, you have a heart. We would never treat anyone with a heart so poorly.
Your son really is fine as I thought. Emotions seem to reach Labyrinth as well, and she's about to smile to answer Mysterio's son. Oh damn, she's being hacked. The impression goes blank, and she suddenly stops moving. Huh? What's going on?
Huh? No, this is recognition signal has been interrupted. Someone is hacking into her.
Recognition signal hacking? What does she mean? Just as I'm about to reach towards Labyrinth.
It's not over yet.
Completely different person's voice from out of Labyrinth's mouth. Upon hearing that, Mysterio-san notices something and don't admire in surprise.
Is this the same communication system we use?
What are you standing around for? Everyone, get away from Labyrinth!
Labyrinth's hand jerkily reaches towards the axe on my back. At the moment's pause, she swings at us all without any hesitation. Yeah, she's definitely being hacked, bro. Like, god fucking damn, man. I've seen this a number of times before, bro. With different characters in the center, bro.
What's going on? I cannot gain access. She's being controlled.
Yeah, by someone else. We don't even know who is even controlling Labyrinth in the... right now.
From inside this facility. The signal originates elsewhere.
You mean outside the TV?
Just a little extra resistance. Now, entertain me.
Damn, Labyrinth dashes towards us with gaze eyes. Just when everyone is shell-shocked by suddenly turns of events, I stand before Labyrinth. Whoever the fuck you are.
Hey, what are you doing? It's too dangerous.
I'll stop her. Isn't this part of protecting her? I need to stop this. I'm arguing.
I don't know what's going on, but there's no way Labyrinth would try to hurt everyone. If someone is controlling Labyrinth, let's put a stop to it. Yeah, and so now I have to fight Labyrinth again, bruh. This time she's being hacked by someone. We don't even know who's even hacking Labyrinth, bruh. So yeah. I draw my fan and face Labyrinth. Also made a promise to her earlier. A promise that I never let her suffer alone.
Please, wake up!
Yeah, we have to fight her again, bruh. Let's go. We're gonna fight her and then end the video, bruh. The reason why it says question mark is because it's someone who's, it's the person who's hacking Labyrinth, so yeah. Come on, bitch. Tough bitch to fucking beat, bro. Anyways, that's it for today's episode, y'all guys. So, yeah. We're gonna see what happens next. As in, Yu-Gi-Oh's ending of the game, bro. So, we'll see that in the next episode, y'all guys. Well, for now, I'll see you guys next time. Watch TV, sign off.